Today, mummies live in museums and movies and, of course, in our nightmares. But how did ancient animals get mummified without help from humans? Hey everyone, thanks for tuning in to DNews today. I'm Trace. In the summer of 2015, a pair of mummified lions were found in the Sakha or Yakutia Republic of northern Russia. Though they don't look it, these lions are 10,000 years old. They were naturally mummified in the ice. These mummified cubs are gobsmacking. Usually time and nature leave only bone fragments, parts of skeletons like skulls or teeth, and maybe, if you're lucky, a carcass. But these lions look as if they fell asleep just yesterday. Of course, they didn't. These are long extinct animals. Lions like these were found from Britain across Eurasia all the way to northwestern Canada during the Pleistocene era, 1.6 million to about 10,000 years ago. The area where they were found has produced a beautifully horrible looking carcass of an Omayakan mammoth called yuka, as well as bison, woolly rhinoceroses, and horses. But the researchers from the Academy of Science of the Republic of Sakha are confident that these are the most well-preserved animals ever found. Natural mummies are an accident of the environment of their death. They're related to the TP-wrapped costumes or classic horror films, but for scientists, mummification is the failure of bacteria to break down soft tissues after death. See, normally, when something dies, the bacteria in, on, and around it immediately begin to break it down. Organs digest themselves in a process called autolysis, and eventually bodies reach the putrefaction phase, where bacteria anaerobically digest the tissue or use oxygen to break it down, pretty much. A few months later, the body is just a skeleton. But sometimes when conditions are just right, these bacteria never get to do their jobs and the organism just dies and simply dries out. In cold, dry conditions, the whole process of putrefaction slows and the body can freeze before bacteria are able to grow and eat away at the corpse. For example, let's see, the Iceman, the oldest, most well-preserved human ever found, was discovered on the Italian Alps in 91 after falling dead under a rocky outcropping. He was quickly covered with snow after he died, creating conditions for him to mummify. The dry desert climate can cause mummification as well. Prior to inventing mummies as we know them from museums today, early Egyptians would bury their dead in small pits and cover them with dry sand. The high heat coupled with a lack of moisture caused dehydration and mummification to happen naturally in a process called desiccation. Once all the moisture was gone and sucked out of the tissues, the bacteria would halt their work. Only later did Egyptians start developing a mummification process as they tried to build tombs, put bodies in them, and found that they would decay too quickly. The hot, dry sand was part of the process, so they altered that to mummify things. The oldest artificially mummified bodies actually don't come from Egypt. They come from Chile. They're 6,500 years old and were placed in the Atacama Desert by the Chinchorro people, complete with wigs and mats for their eternal sleep. Aside from hot and dry or cold and dry, mummies can also naturally form in peat bogs. A peat bog is a form of wetland that accumulates dead plant material called peat. The soil in peat bogs is so saturated and acidic and low in nutrients that creates an environment that is not friendly to oxygen-based anaerobic digestion of biomatter. Though bog mummies aren't as beautiful as those found frozen in glaciers or buried in deserts, the tissues simply aren't as well preserved. According to archaeologist and anthropologist Mark Spiegelman, the tissue of frozen Korean mummies that were found is soft and pliable, while heat-dried Egyptian mummies feels more like paper. Cool. Deserts produce the best mummies because they just desiccate the tissues so quickly. If you pay attention, you'll realize that mummies are actually found all the time. Famous mummies have been found frozen in Greenland, Siberia, Canada, or Korea, and dehydrated mummies are found in Egypt and Nevada, as well as the Atacama. Some are so well preserved, they look like they've only been dead for a few days, like the Kila Kitsok mummies found in 1972. Six Inuit women and two children died under a sheltered overhanging rock, which then the wind freeze-dried their remains, including all their clothing and soft tissues. The younger of the children was only a baby and was so well preserved that he looks like a doll, but is in fact more than 500 years old. Creepy. Mummies can show us what humans or animals looked like in the past, how they lived, what they ate, how they walked based on their wear patterns, and on and on and on, because it's the best resource we have for peeking through a crack into the past. A natural mummy found in China's Taklamakan Desert revealed 3,000 years ago, people who were living there were Indo-Europeans, settling even before the Han Chinese arrived. This discovery completely changed the history of the region, all because we found some mummies. In the end, the most common natural mummies come from hot and dry climes, as the freezing or peat processes tend to not happen as fast. What will we learn from these 10,000-year-old lions, ironically? We don't know yet, time will tell. But for now, that's a wrap. Get it? It's mummy. Mummy joke. If you like jokes that are that bad, check out forhumanpeoples.com, because we have made some of our own DNews t-shirts, just like the one I'm wearing now. Plus, we've got the correlation versus causation shirt, more research is needed, the one with my face on it, and one from our little coffee and poop video as well. Check out the link down in the description, and if you are a first-time buyer, make sure you use the promo code DNews. You'll get 10% off at checkout. They're great. Go buy them. Do you have a science question you'd like us to wrap up for you? A mummy joke. This can't be stopped. Tell me in the comments, and thanks a lot for watching DNews.